not seen the mound train yet.
The rest of the ballpark, sunshine, including the pitcher. Now the 1-2 pitch from Brad Hand. Bounced it in there. What a block by Perez. There, folks, is the difference.
This looks like a 546. What's those letters on there?
What Mitch Garver did in the top of the inning.
That's Perez Detroit.
To his left and just made a
power
sure
plant.
A body.
So this is 546.
Took it off his chest protector, kept the ball in front of him. More importantly, kept Buxton.
This will definitely go to Cleveland.
And some of that's knowing your pitcher. He knows that he's a good slider. At times, it's going to end up in the dirt. 2-2 the count. Buxton with a big lead at second. Hand checks him twice. Hand delivers.
Thank
he
God.
Got him to chase the slider in the other batter's box.
They are very fast, this train.
A big strikeout for Brad Hand of Max Kepler.
There's two outs.
He never
made one.
Any attempt to bunt the runner over to third. The old adage is you play for a tie at home.
Here he comes.
Play for the win on the road, but the Twins did not try to bunt Buxton up to third. Now Jorge Polanco, the batter. The number two will bat right-handed. Polanco has the Twins' first and only legitimate hit.
This is a long cold train.
Ball in right center, scored on a ground out in the first.
6-9-0-1.
With a second hit.
No,
defect. And he pumps the fastball in there for a strike.
Oh, jeez.
Hand.
That was uninspected. The helper should be coming.
Another look back to pitch. Swung out, fist to back, foul on two. He has trying to play it out on third reversal.
Two of them. There's a new wild card.
At first, he did not. I don't know how Polanco weighed off that slider down and in. And again, for the hitters, this is so tough right now. They're in the shadow, and Brad Hand is in bright sunshine.
There you say it's left against right here, but that slider darting in down.